This video is prepared by Avya Classes. Please subscribe the channel, raise your doubt and watch the video for sure success in JEE, AIIMS and NEET.
See some problem based on level 2. First problem is that the ratio of masses of two balls is 2:1 and before collision the ratio of their velocities are 1:2 in mutually opposite direction. After collision, each ball moves in an opposite direction to the initial direction. If coefficient of restitution E is equal to 5/6, you have to find out the ratio of speed of each ball before and after the collision. So how we will solve this problem? The figure pertaining to this problem has already been drawn. If you see that the ratio of masses of two balls are 2:1, that is, if the mass of first ball is 2m and the mass of second ball will be m, and the ratio of their velocities are 1:2, so that's why u1 is written as u and u2 is written as 2u. Now these two balls are moving in mutually opposite direction. So this is the case before collision. After collision, the two balls moves again in the opposite direction. That's why the mass 2m is moving in the left hand side while the mass m is moving in right hand side. Now we have to solve the problem. So basically we have two equations in case of inelastic collision. First is the conservation of momentum. So if we apply the conservation of momentum principle, that is pi is equal to pf, then see the initial momentum is 2m into u minus m into 2u. This is our initial momentum. If we have to calculate the initial momentum, we write in terms of vector form. So 2m into u1 plus m into u2. And if I put the value of vector with the sign, then we get the equation this. We are considering this direction as a positive and the opposite as a negative. So if you see solve it, you will get the initial momentum is equal to 0. So our initial momentum is equal to 0. Now we will calculate the final momentum. So final momentum, that is pf, is again after considering the sign of vector, we may write it m into v2 minus 2m into v1. So this is the case of final momentum, and it must be equal to initial momentum and is equal to 0. So pi is equal to pf, already been drawn. Now second equation is the use of coefficient of restitution, and E is equal to velocity, relative velocity of separation divided by relative velocity of approach. So as these two body are moving in the opposite direction before collision and after collision, so the relative velocity of separation will be equal to v2 plus v1, and relative velocity of approach will be equal to u plus 2u. So from there we get v2 plus v1 divided by u plus 2u. This is the equal to 5/6 as per the equation. So this is our equation 2, this is our equation 1. Now from the equation 1 we can get a relation that v2 is equal to 2v1. So this is the relation in the equation 1, that v2 is equal to 2v1, and if I put the v2 is equal to 2v1 in equation 2, we get a relation between v1 and u. So putting the value of v2 is equal to 2v1, so 2v1 plus v1 divided by 3u is equal to 5/6, and from there we get 3v1 by 3u is equal to 5/6, and v1 by u is equal to 5/6. So v1 is the velocity of ball after collision and u is the velocity of ball before collision. You have to find out the ratio of speed of each ball before and after collision. So for the first ball, the ratio of speed will be 5/6. On the similar note, if we solve it, we get v2 by 2u is equal to 5/6. Anyway, we can solve it out. So from there, from the equation 2 itself, you just put a value of v2. So v2 by 2u is equal to, v2 is equal to 2v1 and 2u, so it's again comes equal to v1 by u, and it's equal to 5 by 6. So ratio of velocity of both body after and before collision will be 5 by 6 times. Answer will be A. So what is our approach? Our approach in elastic collision to consider focus on two equations. First, the conservation of momentum, and second, the use of coefficient of restitution. And believe me, it's very easy to solve. If you get any doubt, you just try by yourself again and again, and you will become expertise in this. So after doing practice only, you will be able to solve problems. So believe me, just do practice. So the next problem is, a body of mass 3 kg moving with a speed of 4 meter per second collides head on with a stationary ball of mass 2 kg. Their relative velocity of separation after the collision is equal to 2 meter per second. Then you have given 4 options. You have to find out which option is true. It may possible that more than one option will be correct. So how we will solve this problem? First, we will draw the figure pertaining to problem. If this problem comes objective, still you try to solve through the figure, because if you draw the figure for any problem, if you draw the sketch, the problem becomes very easy usually, as you get a rough idea about problem. So a body of mass 3 kg, this is our 3 kg mass body, which is moving with a speed of 4 meter per second, and it collides with a stationary ball having mass equal to 2 kg, and the velocity we keep it is equal to u1 and u2 is equal to 0. They are related. This is the case before collision. This is the case before collision, and after collision the relative velocity, this is 3 2, this is moving with, suppose it's moving with v1, this is moving with v2. So this is the case after collision, and it is written here that the relative velocity of separation after the collision is 2 meter per second. So relative velocity of separation, what is the relative velocity of separation as per the figure? It is v2 minus v1. So v2 minus v1 is equal to 2 meter per second. Now if you see the figure first before collision, so what is the relative velocity of approach? It's 4 meter per second. So relative velocity of approach is equal to 4 meter per second. So sometimes it is quite possible that only one option will be correct, and in this case the coefficient of restitution, see, you have to calculate the coefficient of restitution, impulse and loss of kinetic energy. These three terms pertaining to this problem you have to calculate and check that which is correct. So first we will calculate the coefficient of restitution, and is the relative velocity of separation divided by relative velocity of approach. So from there we get E is equal to 2 by 4 and 1 by 2, that is 0.5. So option A is correct. Now we will see the loss of kinetic energy. Now we'll calculate the loss of kinetic energy. So we will note it down here, loss of kinetic energy, and the formula is that 1 by 2 m1 m2 divided by m1 plus m2, 1 minus e square u1 minus u2 whole square. So you should remember this formula, as these are very handy. So if I put the all values, then m1 into m2 is equal to 3 into 2 divided by 3 plus 2, 1 minus e square, it is 1 minus 1 by 4, and u1 minus u2, that is 4 square. Now you just calculate this value, that 1 by 2, 6 by 5 into 3 by 4 into 16, and the value finally comes equal to 36 by 5, that is equal to 7.2 joule. So the loss of kinetic energy due to collision is equal to 7.2 joule. So the answer D is also correct. Now we will calculate the impulse and see that whenever the impulse of collision comes equal to 7.2 Newton second or not. So as we know that the impulse in case of collision, like if this is the collision, so impulse is equal to change in momentum. So I just note it down here. You have already learned this concept in the law of motion. So impulse is equal to change in momentum, or in terms of formula we may write that F dot delta t, this is the value of impulse, and it is equal to Pf minus Pi. So impulse is equal to change momentum. You have to calculate the impulse of this collision. So consider the first body whose velocity will be changing with him. So first body, the initial velocity is equal to 4 meter per second, and after the collision the velocity changes to v1. So what you will do, you will first calculate the velocity v1 and then you calculate the change in momentum. So again you have to use this formula. If you can remember, the velocity of ball after collision in case of inelastic collision will be v is equal to m1 minus em2 divided by m1 plus m2 u1 plus 1 plus em2 u2 divided by m1 plus m2. Here as u2 is equal to 0, so the second term will be equal to 0, and you get v1 is equal to m1. So m1 is equal to 3 minus em2, e is equal to 1 by 2, m2 is 2, so 3 minus 1 divided by 3 plus 2, that is equal to 5, and into u, so u1 is equal to 4, so 2 into 4 divided by 5, and the value comes equal to 8 by 5 meter per second. So after collision the velocity of this body will be 8 by 5 meter per second. Now we will calculate the change in momentum. So Pf is equal to final momentum, and final momentum turns out to be 8 by 5 into 3. Momentum is mass into velocity, so this is the mass, this is the velocity, so it's equal to 24 by 5, and Pi is equal to the initial momentum is equal to four into three, that is 12. So Pf minus Pi, if you calculate, Pf minus Pi is equal to 24 by 5 minus 12, and it comes equal to 24 minus 60 by 5, and it's 36 by minus 36 by 5, that is minus 7.2. So the impulse of this collision is 7.2 Newton second. In fact, for this body the impulse will be negative, and you may calculate the impulse in other way also, like as for the second body the initial momentum is equal to 0, you just calculate the value of v2. So again you apply the formula for v2, get this value of v2, get the final momentum, that is Pf for this second body, and initial momentum of it will be 0. So whatever will be the change in momentum, it will be equal to impulse. So this problem is in fact very good. This problem contains three separate problems in itself. So you know how you calculate coefficient of restitution, you know how you calculate the impulse of collision, how you calculate the loss of kinetic energy. You may also calculate that what is the kinetic energy retained by the body. So in this way we solve such kinds of problem. I would like to suggest you that you try to solve this problem by yourself. Now we move to next problem. This is also a good problem, although it's a easy problem. A particle of mass m1 move moves with speed u and collides head-on with an stationary particle of mass m2. The first particle continues to move in the same direction if m1 and m2 is. So basically it is given that two particles are mass m1 and m2 respectively, and this m2 is equal to 0, and this particle is moving with a speed u. This is the case before collision, and after collision, and this particle is moving with a velocity v1, and this particle is moving with a velocity v2. So clearly you have to calculate that if the coefficient of restitution is e, then the first particle continue to move in the same direction, so the direction of v1 will be equal to direction, so will be direction of u. You have to calculate the condition for that. So what is our criteria? We have to find out direction of v1 is equal to direction of u under what condition? What condition? So again we will calculate. If you apply the formula for v1, then v1 is equal to m1 minus e m2 divided by m1 plus m2 into u1 plus m2 1 plus e u2 divided by m1 plus m2. So clearly as u is 0, so this term, whole term, will turns out to be 0, and v1 is equal to m1 minus e m2 divided by m1 plus m2 into u1. Now as we have already calculated this direction as a positive direction, so the direction of u and v1 will be same if v1 will be greater than 0. So v1 will be greater than 0 if m1 minus e m2 is greater than 0, and we get m1 will be greater than e m2 and m1 by m2 greater than e. So this is our criteria. If m1 by m2 or the ratio of masses will be greater than e, then the body will move in the same direction, and it is a very useful concept. Like if you calculate from their figure, if m1 and m2 is equal to e, then the first body will stop, or the projectile will stop, target will move. So this is our projectile, this is our target. M1 is projectile, M2 is target. So if M1 by M2 is equal to 1, then projectile will stop. If M1 by M2 is less than E, then projectile will move in opposite direction. In opposite direction, like if it is moving towards the right hand side, then it will return back in the left hand side or left hand direction. And if m1 by m2 is greater than e, then projectile will move in same direction. So I just give you a glimpse of such kind of problems. So like suppose that you may be asked this problem also in this way. Like suppose e is equal to 1 by, if the coefficient of restitution will be equal to 1 by 3, so which condition or what should be the ratio of masses for the projectile will be in rest after the collision? So if the option will be 2 and 6, 1 and 3, 5 and 15, so if these are the cases, then if these are the ratio of masses, then the projectile or this projectile, that is 2 kg, 1 kg or 5 kg, will be rest after the collision. And if E is equal to 1 by 2, then the ratio of masses will be changes for the collision. So if consider the case like 2 kg and this is mass M, and the coefficient of restitution is E is equal to 1 by 3. Now, if M is equal to 6 kg, then after collision, this 2 kg mass will be in rest. If M is greater than 6 kg, then this 2 kg mass will return back after the collision. And if M is less than 6 kg, then this 2 kg mass will move in the same direction. So this is the basic concept of this problem. That's why I have included this problem also in the list of problem, as it gives you an idea that in case of inelastic collision, whenever the ball moves in the same direction or it will return back, it will stop. It all depends on the coefficient of restitution.